town with the great football team. We cheer the Pittsburgh Steelers. Hey guys, welcome to Pittsburgh. This is Anthony. I appreciate you joining me for another one of these sports card investing videos. Today I have a different video than you may have seen on YouTube. Today I want to talk about some guys that are undervalued. I want to talk about some guys that not everybody is picking up, because I actually had a comment on Reddit. I posted one of my sports card investing videos and they were like, man, you're investing in Ja, Luka. They mentioned these bigger name players that I've been investing in. And they're like, well, that's not telling me anybody that I'm not already buying. So that comment actually challenged me to come up with some guys that not everybody's investing in, some lower tier guys that I think because of some off-season moves or the way that this season is set up, since this is an untraditional season, they may have a little bit more of an edge. And I'm not saying that these guys are going to go out and they're going to become like the next Giannis or Kawhi or whatnot guy that was drafted a bit later in the first round or in the second round, and then next thing you know, they're one of the best in the league. I'm not saying that. What I'm saying is I believe that the guys that I'm going to give you on this list, I believe their card prices will go up this NBA season. And these are all guys that you can buy into their rookie cards reasonably low. So without further ado, I want to start talking about some of these guys. The very first guy I want to talk about is a rookie in 2017-2018 season. He plays for the Atlanta Hawks. His name is John Collins. And I really believe that this guy has a lot of potential. Now, he's probably the most established player on this list that I'm going to share, if that says anything to you. He's already a starter, but I really believe that his value is going to go up. He's surrounded by a lot of young talent, and I believe that him and Trae Young are going to have great rapport together, plus a lot of the other young pieces that they've added around them. Now they've also got Clint Capella there to kind of help clean the glass and play defense and whatnot, so I could definitely see John Collins taking a big step forward this year. And most of the people that are investing in the Hawks, they're going for Trae Young first and foremost, and then they're going for some of the other younger guys like Cam Reddish, DeAndre Hunter, guys like that. I could definitely see John Collins getting a big upgrade in his prices this upcoming season. The next guy that I think has a really great opportunity to see a jump in his prices was a rookie in 2018-2019. His name is Robert Williams. He was drafted by the Boston Celtics. And the reason I think he has potential this upcoming year is because he may get an opportunity to start. And if he enters that starting lineup, I believe that this guy is ready to take the next step. Next guy I want to talk about, this is one of the better free agents this year. He very well could go back to Detroit. Talking about Christian Wood, the Pistons let Andre Drummond, their longtime all-star center, go. They traded him to the Cleveland Cavaliers, the best team on God's green earth. But being that they let Drummond go, that means that they're opening themselves up to potentially move forward with Wood being a bigger part of their team. So Christian Wood is definitely a guy to, if you can grab his stuff on the cheap, whether he stays in Detroit, he's up for increased minutes and a bigger role, or if he goes somewhere else, clearly he's going to be one of the more prized free agents this year. So if you're able to find any Christian Wood cards on the cheap, or if you have any, they may be worth stashing for at least a few months until we're into the next season, because his value could definitely go up. The next thing I want to talk about that I could definitely see being a big time six man this upcoming year, or depending on what kind of trades the team makes, could kind of squeak his way in as a starter, Eric Paschal for the Golden State Warriors. Now, he looked really good in his rookie year, and now he's going to have another season under his belt, and he's going to have Hall of Fame caliber players all around him. So I definitely could see him having a nice little leap in his second year from his first year. So I would definitely see him playing kind of like a Kyle Kuzma type role with the Warriors, coming off of the bench and just being a valuable six man. And I think that's something that's going to really help his card prices as well. The next guy that I really am huge on
And this guy's card prices aren't super low to begin with. They're a little bit higher because he does kind of have a cult following. But this guy proved in the bubble why he is so valuable. And I could definitely see him being a much bigger part of his team going forward. And I'm talking about Alex Caruso, the bald eagle from the LA Lakers. This guy is clutch. He has that it factor. And I could totally see his prices continuing to increase as the Lakers are going to be one of the teams that are favored to win it all again. And I really think Caruso has a lot of potential, guys. I would not hesitate to pick up any of his stuff because, like I said, regardless of how he's performed on the court, which has been fantastical, he has a cult following in Los Angeles. That means this dude is like the biggest thing since sliced bread there. You know, I don't know if you remember like Lin Sanity several years ago with Jeremy Lin. I'm not comparing it to that, but he has a similar cult following. I definitely could see his prices taking a nice little jump. Another guy that could theoretically, based on offseason moves, find his way into the starting lineup this next year is Darius Bazley with the OKC Thunder. And the reason I say that is because Gallinari's getting a little bit older. Not that he's a bad player or anything like that, but he theoretically could be moved as this team is looking to rebuild. So if that's the case, Bazley's in line for a crack as a starter. And I think that he has a lot of potential moving forward. So if you can pick up any Bazley cards on the cheap, or if you have them, they might be worth holding on to if he gets any kind of substantial minutes moving forward. Another guy that I think has big time potential, and I'm huge on him, he saw some pretty good playoff minutes this past year in the bubble, is Matisse Thybulle for the 76ers. I really think Thybulle has the potential to take his game to the next level. He's already a sound defender, and I definitely think he has the makings of an all-around good 3-and-D player. I think that he's capable of more than that. Plus, the fact that he has a very successful YouTube channel, I think that also bodes very well for his prices. Now, guys that can give you value off of the court as well are always worth having. So if you can find any Thybulle on the cheap, he's a guy that would be worth potentially investing in moving forward. Another guy that I think his team could potentially throw him into a much bigger role, especially should Fred VanVleet not resign, is Terrence Davis of the Toronto Raptors. He exceeded all of the expectations from this past year. And there's so many people in Toronto that are huge on him. I have a good friend that lives over in Toronto that has told me that this guy looks like he's the truth. So if you have any Terrence Davises, hold on to them. If you can find them on the cheap, grab a couple because he may be in line for a bigger role moving forward. Another guy that I think could be big time moving forward, especially with some talent that's coming in around him, is Spencer Dinwiddie of the Brooklyn Nets. I feel like he's one of the most underrated players in the NBA, and I feel like he's been for years. But now he's going to be on a team with Kyrie Irving and Kevin Durant. Now, not so much the Kyrie Irving side of things, because he's been shown to not be the best leader of teams on his own. But Kevin Durant, I believe, is going to be a game changer on that team. I believe just him there alone, teams are going to have to account for him. So I believe that there's going to be other players that are going to see added shine because teams are going to be trying to shut down Durant and Irving. And I think Dinwiddie's one of those guys. So very well could see Dinwiddie's stock begin to rise early into this next season. Another good guy that I've been stashing because I think he has potential for a much bigger role next season is Keldon Johnson of the Spurs. I think he'll definitely get more playing time this upcoming NBA season, and I think he's definitely a guy to be on the lookout for that I have on my list. Another guy that I think is huge, that has big time potential, that may not see it this upcoming season, but I think he will be a starter caliber player in the future, is Anthony Simons of the Portland Trailblazers. Now, a lot of his potential is kind of wrapped up in Dame Lillard and CJ McCollum. So depending on what happens with those two and everything like that, or if he gets moved to another team or something like that happens, I think Anthony Simons has the makings of a very good starting guard in the NBA. So I definitely think that he's one that could see a little bit of a spike in his card prices as well. Guys, do me a favor. Let me know some players that you think are very underrated traded and you think their card prices are going to go up this season. I tried to think outside of the box on this one. I didn't try to pick best player on any team or anything like that. So I tried to kind of go down the list. I tried to look logically at some rosters and just pull a few guys out that I think have some potential that you can get at a lower price or that not everybody is running after to try to make money on. These are guys that I feel good about right now. Again, these aren't guys I'm saying, go out, spend all your money on these guys. These are guys that are those lower end guys that right now you can get pretty cheap and you can make a moderate increase on. I'm not saying these are going to be the next Lucas. These are going to be the next LeBrons. I'm saying these are going to be guys that are going to take a little bit of a jump going into this next season because they're going to get more of a role. And as they get more of a role, if they have one or two good games or something like that happens, you're going to see a spike in their prices. So without further ado, that is the list I have compiled for you guys. I would love to hear your feedback on it. And if you would, drop a thumbs up on this video because that does help me. It tells YouTube that I'm doing something good. And if you're not already subscribed, make sure you subscribe to the channel because we're on our road to 2,000 subscribers. And when we hit 2K, we're doing a little something called Slabs or Cash. And what that means is you will have an opportunity to win one of my two favorite things, either slabs, which would be great cards, you'd have your choice of them, or cold hard cash. Guys, make sure you stay tuned to the channel. There's going to be lots of awesome stuff coming, and I will see you guys in the next one. May God bless.